Hello guys, today I want to introduce you electric circuits. And here the first circuit I want to introduce you is a simple electric circuit. In this circuit we have a battery, we have a switch over here, and we have a bulb. Now the resistance of the bulb, as you see here, is 10 ohms, while the voltage across the battery is 10 volts. And when I close the switch, I see that the current is flowing through the circuit. If I want to measure this current flowing through the circuit, I connect my ammeter over here, and I see that this is equal to 1 ampere. Now, to measure the voltage across the terminals of the battery or across the bulb, I connect my voltmeter across the bulb and measure the voltage to be equal to 10 volts. You can easily see that this voltage across the terminals of this bulb is exactly equal to the voltage of the battery. So in a simple electric circuit, the current flowing through the circuit can be easily calculated by using Ohm's law. Remember, in Ohm's law, the voltage is equal to the current flowing through the circuit multiplied by the resistance of the circuit. In order to calculate the current flowing through the circuit, then you divide the voltage to the resistance, and in our circuit over here, you divide, to find the current flowing through the circuit, you divide the voltage, which is equal to 10 volts, to the resistance of the circuit, which is again 10 ohms, and you obtain the current flowing through the circuit to be 1 ampere. Now let us consider the second one. In this second circuit, we have three bulbs connected end to end, as you see over here. And as you see, we have a single circuit which is containing three bulbs with different resistors, and the bulb has resistances of 10 ohms, 20 ohms, and 10 ohms. So when I close my switch, I see that all of these lamps are giving off light. So I can measure the current and the voltage across each of these elements. Let me first measure the potential difference, the voltage across each element. I see that the voltage across the first lamp, the first bulb, is 2.5 volts. And then I measure the one over here, and I see that this is equal to 5 volts. And the one over here on the third is going to be 2.5 again, because it has the same resistance as the first one over here. So the potential difference across each element is going to be 2.5 on that, and 5 volts over this, and finally 2.5 volts across the last resistor over here. If I measure the potential across all of these elements, then in that case I see that this is equal to 10 volts. And I shift my voltmeter and connect it to the terminals of the battery. Again, it is going to be 10 volts. So simply I can easily see that the voltage across all these elements, the sum of the voltage across all these elements, is equal to the voltage of the battery. So adding the voltages across all these elements, 2.5 plus 5 equals 7.5. And finally, if I connect the voltmeter across all these elements, I see that this is equal to 10 volts. So you add them up all together to find the voltage of the battery. In order to measure the current flowing through the circuit, then I can find it by connecting my ammeter to the wire, and I see that this is 0.25 ampere. From Ohm's law, I know that the current flowing through the circuit multiplied by the total resistance of all these elements should give me the voltage of the battery. So this is 10, and if I want to obtain the resistance, then this is going to be the voltage divided by the current flowing through the circuit, which gives me 40 ohms. So how do I get this value? You can simply add all these resistances to obtain the equivalent resistance, which is the total resistance of the circuit. So the equivalent resistance of a series circuit is going to be 10 plus 20 plus 10, which is equal to 40 ohms. And this can be obtained from Ohm's law, as I said, by dividing the voltage, which is equal to 10 volts, divided by the current flowing through the circuit is equal to 0.25 amperes. So this is going to be again 40, as you see. So in series circuit, to find the equivalent resistance of the circuit, I just add the individual resistances of the bulbs to obtain the total resistance of the circuit, which is called equivalent resistance of the circuit. And another characteristic of this series circuit is that the elements in the circuit work together, and when you close the switch and when you open the switch, they all go off. So they work together and they stop working together. This is a characteristic of series circuits. Now finally I want to discuss the parallel electric circuits. In this case, here we have again three bulbs which are connected. Each one is directly connected to the battery. So you see that, here we have three independent electric circuits. The first one I want to show you here, the circuit of this first bulb is this one. The circuit of the second one is the one over here, the second circuit, and this is the third. So all these elements in this circuit are working independently. You see that here the bulb is giving off light, but this one, as you close the switch, also gives off light, and finally the third one works again independently. When you open the switch, only that bulb goes off and the others are still working. So the first characteristic of the parallel circuit is that all these elements are connected independently to the battery and they work independently. This is the first characteristic of the parallel circuit. The household circuit is a parallel circuit. Why? Because simply when I want to watch TV, I don't want to use another device at the same time. For example, when the washing machine is working, I don't want the television to be also working, which is if I connect them in series, they are going to all work together. And this is usually I mean, simply nonsense, you know. So I want each device in the household circuit to work independently, and when there is a break in one of the circuit, only this element is going to have a problem. We are going to have a problem only with this element. The other are still going to work independently. So the household circuit is a parallel circuit. Now, let us turn back and measure the current flowing through the circuit and the voltage across each element in the circuit. So I connect my voltmeter to the terminals of the battery first, and I see that this is equal to the voltage across the battery. The terminals of the battery is 10 volts. I shift my voltmeter up over here. I see that still I measure the same voltage. In fact, the voltage across each of these bulbs is the same as the voltage of the battery. So, this is a characteristic of the parallel circuit. The voltage across each of these elements in the circuit is equal to the voltage of the battery. So I shift it over here. As you see, the potential difference doesn't change, and it is equal to 10 volts. So the first characteristic of the parallel circuit was that the elements in the circuit are working independently, and the second characteristic is that the voltage across each of these elements is equal to the voltage of the battery, which is 10 volts. Now, to calculate the current flowing through each branch, we call those branches, you know, we have three branches over here, and the current flowing through each element can be calculated from Ohm's law again. The voltage across the bulb is equal to 10 volts divided by the resistance, which is again 10 ohms, and the current flowing through this branch is going to be 1 ampere. The one over here is going to be again 1 ampere, and I know that the current flowing through this branch should be 2 amperes then, because it comes over here, 1 ampere goes there, and 1 ampere goes to the upper branch. So the current flowing through this branch is going to be 2 amperes, and we have here again 1 ampere, which again can be calculated from Ohm's law, which is equal to 10 divided by 10. 10, the voltage across the bulb, divided by the resistance of the bulb, which is equal to 10 ohms, and this gives me again 1 ampere. So in the main branch over here, I am going to have a current of 3 amperes, as you see. A current of 3 amperes we have. And it comes over here, 1 goes over there, 2 up, and then this is divided into 2, and the current flowing through each element is 1 ampere. In the main branch, a current of 3 amperes flows. So in order to calculate the equivalent resistance of the circuit, I just simply divide the voltage to the resistance, equivalent resistance, and this gives me 3 amperes, which is the main current flowing through the circuit. So the equivalent resistance of the circuit is going to be 10 divided by 3, which is equal to 3.3 ohms. So let me repeat again. The current flowing through the main branch is equal to 3 amperes. The voltage across the circuit is 10 volts. Using Ohm's law, then you divide the voltage to the current flowing through the circuit, and this gives you the equivalent resistance of the circuit. So we have finished discussing the electric circuits. See you then.